So this thing is really a pretty awesome piece of glass. EFM 11-22mm. Oh, you gotta be shitting me. Fucking fire alarm. Oh my god.
I think I'll go buy a new camera lens today. Oh man! Jeez! Bloody hell! We've gone from summer to overnight winter. I better get changed. Woo! Now I'm dressed for overnight winter.
And you know what else I'm having to play with today? The Feiyutech A1000 gimbal. But you know, the Feiyutech A1000 gimbal,
that's gonna be a video for another time.
Alright, I've got everything. Wallet, cell phone, keys.
Yeah, I think I've got everything.
So you may be asking yourself, why do you need the 11 to 22? Well, it's about content. And not having the camera shoved right up in your face. I currently have the 15-45mm lens on my camera. That's the kit lens for the Canon EOS M6. You know what, let's not vlog while we're driving.
Come and see why you should be on Easy Street. You'll be out of front row seat. Like that can't be beat right here on Easy Street.
Because you know, I'm totally Negan. I am totally Negan. I was always Negan.
So if you're not sort of totally up to play on the whole lens thing, you know, the longer a lens is, the longer the number, that means the more it zooms in. So you want a low number to be like zoomed out. You know, like if you've got a 200mm lens, you know, like if I had a 200mm lens on my face right now, you know, it'd be like this. You'd see my eyes and that's it. Yeah. And you want to be able to hold the camera out in a comfortable enough distance, but get lots of the context around you to show where you are. And so the kit lens at 15mm, while it's adequate, it's still a bit close, you know? My ugly mug has taken up too much of the space. Heading into the shopping mall, JB's Hi-Fi, get the 11-22mm lens.
Yeah. 22, 11, quite a bit of a, yeah, pretty good.
EFM, 11-22mm. Oh, you gotta be shitting me.
That's not a drill. What time did we get out of the bloody mall?
Alright, well I'm parked on the mezzanine floor, so that's where I'm going. It's probably just a false alarm, not like a fire alarm. I don't think it's serious. You can see the shopkeepers closing the doors around me.
I haven't even had a chance to take it out of the box yet. Make it crazy if you caught up in the world while it's done. This is like a product review gone totally wrong.
There's just this mass exodus everywhere. So like if you're in the movies, you know, the alarm's going off and it's like, evacuate the building.
Everyone, get the fuck out of the building.
I suppose it's going to be great for people to get a park now because it was so hard getting a park to come here. And like, new people will be pulling into the mall car park and it's like, great, I can get a park, there's heaps of parks. And then you'll be walking up to the doors and it'll be like, oh, I can't get in. That alarm's still going and there's a massive queue to get out now. I'm in a queue of cars waiting to get out. So it is a fire alarm. Unfortunately, I didn't get the fire engine on camera. engine. Man, talk about disruption. Like thousands of people forced to get out of the building. Time to get your kid, cause this is time, motherfucker, time, motherfucker, time. Well, it's only 15 minutes now after the fire, and the fire engine is behind me. False alarm, false alarm. All right, we're clear of the mall, and the craziness, and the queues. Now let's drop the dangerous road. Okay, so why is it important for you to get a wide angle lens for your camera? The lens currently on this camera, the 15-45 kit lens, you're going to get a lot more context with the 11-22 or any wider angle lens. Alright, so I got my gimbal set up on a table here. Now if this wasn't the gimbal, it could just be a tripod. And you know, this is a perfect example of what a wide angle lens will do for you. It'll give you context. It's on the very edge, and I'm basically sat back as far as I can go, and the top of my head is cut off. So let's change to the 11-22mm on the clap. So without adjusting anything, without moving the gimbal and camera back at all, without, you know, sitting further back in the seat, I'm in exactly the same place. You know, now my head's not cut off, you can see a lot more around me, and this is what's called context. The downside to getting a wide-angle lens like this is you give up bokeh. Bokeh is background blur, and that only happens when you're kind of like zoomed in. So for example, if I had the camera on a tripod way, way, way back, and I was zoomed in, like maybe a 55 to 200 millimeter zoom lens, and I was zoomed in, you know, and then I had the same framing, everything in the background would be all blurred. That would be what you call bokeh. So yeah, this is what you get with a wide angle lens. That's the difference. So let's change back. And now back to this. That's the difference. And you know, for vlogging, you know, picking up the old, you know, gimbal, tripod, you know, whatever it is, you know, your selfie stick, this is going to give you a lot of, you know, showing you a lot of what, where you are. And for vlogging, that's important, because vlogging is all about, you know, traveling, you know, where I am, where I'm going, where I've been, where I am now. Right now I'm at the riverside. D-man, that's for you. Hissing thoughts, duckies. So anyway, yeah. What a disaster of a video, honestly. Just, you go to do a little wee unboxing and you get a fucking fire alarm. Fucking hell. Anyway, in the future I will have to do a comparison of, you know, the 11-22mm lens with the 15-45 kit lens, and in the future I will get the 22mm prime lens as well. So I've got that to look forward to one day.